Good morning, everyone. I'm going to speak about one procedure that I am doing for almost 3 years, and is the breast augmentation. Let's go to talk first about the statistics that for me are very important, the statistics. I am a cosmetic surgeon, so I'm going to talk my experience as a cosmetic surgeon that probably will be different than a reconstructive surgeon or doctors who works in the hospital. So I'm going to give you my experience for 30 years just working cosmetic surgery. So in 2006, I do the 25% of my cosmetic surgeries were breast surgeries. In 2016, don't change too much. So it will be the same. Almost 22% of all my surgeries were breast surgeries. But this is the most important and what I am here. And I want to give you my experience. The 65% in all the breast surgeries were breast augmentation. The second, breast lift. So with those two surgical procedures, the mastopexy and the breast augmentation, is almost the 85% of the surgeries in that time, in 2006. In 2016, changed a little bit. Not too much, but changed a little bit. If you see, the 50% of the breast surgeries in cosmetic surgery, it was breast augmentation. The other, it was gynecomasty that I didn't see any in 2006. Now my second most common breast surgery is gynecomasty. And then breast replacement is another important point. In that time, just it was breast augmentation, but now I'm replacing another, change the implant with my patients or another patient for the other doctors. And the number third, mastopexy. So with this fourth surgery, almost all my breast surgeries as a cosmetic surgeon is for almost the 90% of my procedures. Why this approach? I learned almost all the approach in this society. In that time, I'm talking about 25 years ago, I spent almost 6 months with Dr. Thomas Stephenson, and he showed me how to put the implant by the axillary incision. So I was doing in that time, because my teacher showed me the way, the axillary approach. And then with Dr. Morgan, I learned the areolar approach, and I do several too. And the inframammary approach with Dr. Brennan, who was yesterday here with you. I spent 1 year with him, talking about 29 years old. But in 2006, I say my patient, decide what approach do you want? And this was the 85% decide inframammary approach, and the other the rest. And now, in 2016, all my approach is the inframammary incision, because almost I try to convince my patients that is the best approach, talking about me. I respect the other approach, I respect the implants, what kind, I respect under the muscle, about the muscle. I respect all of you, just I'm telling you my experience in this field. 2017, still, the 20% of my surgeries was breast surgeries, almost 4 patients or 5 patients per week. Still, number one, breast augmentation. And now why is it muscular? Because usually I put under the mammary gland. Because my patient asked me this approach, or some patients that have, because I replaced the implant and they have under the muscle, so I put the implant again under the muscle. And look at this, gynecomasty 28, and the other two is still mastopexy and breast replacement. Still, the number, the 90% in all the cosmetic surgeries. Last year, still 20% of my patients are breast surgeries. The number one, breast augmentation. And look at the gynecomasty. The gynecomasty show me a lot. I'm going to show you what the gynecomasty show me and why it still confirm my approach for breast augmentation. And still, mastopexy and breast replacement are the almost the 90% of the surgeries. Complications, honestly, in just two complications in my patients, and I'm honest with you. This is the hematomas, but I have the 5% of my patients, okay? So in every 25 patients, I have one hematoma. And the other is the capsule second grade. That is, and the third grade is very unusual. When my patient comes with me for breast surgery, and then my assistants took the pictures, before to see the patient, I put this information to her.
At Evo Clinic, we help you improve your physical appearance with breast augmentation surgery. A cosmetic procedure where implants are placed to enhance the breast size and as a result contribute to a better silhouette. Women who decide to undergo a breast augmentation surgery are usually looking to improve their self-image. With breast augmentation, you can increase the breast projection, refine the body shape and balance, improve self-image, elevate self-esteem. During the breast augmentation procedure, the surgeon will lift skin and tissue and then carefully insert the implant, which is a small plastic bag filled with silicone. There are two techniques to place the implant. One is under the breast tissue or subglandular position, and second, under the pectoral muscle or submuscular position. The surgeon will suggest which one is recommended for each patient. Then he will create the space required to place the implant, either under the breast tissue or the muscle. Then he will place the implant through the incision previously made to finally close with soluble sutures. It is very important to acknowledge that a breast augmentation surgery will not correct saggy breasts. The cosmetic surgeon will suggest an aesthetic procedure to help you improve your results. The surgeon can offer to increase the breast size and also lift them, with a combination of breast lift with augmentation at the same surgical time. With the proper care, results from a breast augmentation surgery are long-lasting. Your new self-image will give you the freedom and confidence to wear certain kind of clothes, as well as increasing your self-esteem. This procedure takes between 1 to 2 hours. Best candidates are women with small or disproportionate breasts, with fallen or deformed breasts as a result of breastfeeding. In Evo Clinic, we offer a specialized medical staff with the experience of Dr. Jose Luis Salas to provide the best service. Evo Clinic, beauty evolved.
So after that, I can talk with my patient in my office. But the first, let me talk a little bit about the gynecomastia. This is the ideal patient for gynecomastia. To me, it's a very easy surgery. I remove all the fat around the mammary gland. And then I do the incision by the areola, that is the best approach. And then I can remove all the mammary gland. This is a really mastectomy, okay? After remove all the, almost all the fat, we left the mammary gland, that is very hard, and then we remove all the mammary gland. But one thing, show me this surgical technique is the mammary gland is under the skin, under the skin and above the superficial fascia. So that is very important because where I'm going to put the implant in the girls, okay? So if you see, I take all the mammary gland and I let just the areola and the nipple, and I remove all the mammary gland. You see the, also it's different in every patient. Look at this, this is a little bit different. So I need to touch, I need to feel the fascia, the muscle, and I don't have any mammary gland there and no fat around. So because it's a big space, sometimes I let this Penrose or sometimes a drain, depends on the patient. But look, the areola and the nipple. And the areola and the nipple is part of the skin. So I remove all the, and I have several years and several patients with this procedure, never a necrosis in the areola, never a necrosis in the nipple. And I remove all the mammary gland, and I remove all the fat around, and that is part of the skin. So if we do a mastopexy, it's very, very difficult that you damage the areola and the nipple, but never in my patients. Okay, this is a patient after 1 month. This is 5 years later. This is another patient. This is 1 month with this deformity at the beginning, but 3 years later is like nothing. So those are my patients in my clinic for mastopexy. And look, I remove all the mammary gland, always different, like in the woman, is the same, different. Always I took these pictures and I show in the and I put in the file and I show you my patient in the next interview, what I remove and I will take it out. Now let's go to talk again about my approach for the breast augmentation. If with the inframammary approach, I never touch the mammary gland and I never touch the most important structures. That is, first, the mammary gland, second, the fat of the mammary gland, and number third, the most important, the arteries and veins that are around the mammary gland. I never touch that. So it's a very, very safe surgery. Okay, I already finished a gynecomasty. This is the mammary gland of the patient, but almost it's the same in the woman. So one is a little bit bigger than the other, but that is not a big deal. The thing is, exactly how is this mammary gland, because this is just real, real mammary gland. We don't have almost fat. This is fat, the yellow color is fat, and the white color is the mammary gland. So just I'm going to try to do that. This part of here, it was where is the nipple. This is the nipple. I do the incision here, and then I cut exactly because the connection with the nipple, with the mammary gland, we need to cut this area, okay? Then we can undermine the rest of the mammary gland around, and then I leave this. And if you see, this is real, real mammary gland. This is not, this is no fat. And then under the mammary gland is like a fascia. And this is the real fascia. That is the reason, but between this fascia, and imagine that this is the fascia of the muscle. So always in the breast augmentation, I put the implant where is the fascia, and this is the other fascia, and then I put the mammary gland under the muscle, behind the fascia of the mammary gland, and over the fascia of the muscle. So I think that this is the best sample that I can explain. Okay? Thank you. I say something, a mistake there, but this, the implant is between the superficial fascia and the fascia of the muscle. Okay, that is the most important to me, to put the implant between those two fascias. Why I prefer this technique until now, the incision is in the inframammary fold, and this camouflage. The patient is without clothes, and nobody notices anything. And sometimes it's just a line that is more noticeable when they put the bra to tie that, you know, that the scar. I never touched the mammary gland, never. And the surgery is very fast and it's very convenient. The anatomic procedure is without any lesion structures that are important that I told you before and you can see in the anatomy. And it's easy if we have the number one of the complications immediately, that is the hematoma. So to resolve that is very easy for any very good surgeon. Just to show some patients that is a noticeable the incision
Another patient 13 years later, almost the incision is unnoticeable. Another 20 years later, almost the incision is unnoticeable.
The surgical technique is very easy. I use the tumescent technique, and the tumescent technique is I try to undermine the fascia superficial with the fascia of the muscle. So I try to put that solution, the tumescent solution. So it's like undermine that space. Okay, the incision is 4, sometimes 5 centimeters, depends of the implant. If it's 200, 250, depends of the implant. Always I try to see the fascia of the pectoralis major, and I create or I do a space between fascias with blunt dissection, always blunt dissection. And this suture is the most important because I use the Bicryl to close the superficial fascia, and then I avoid tension in that. And also with the same Bicryl, the subdermical, then I don't have tension in the incision, so the incision is just aligned. I never saw in 3 years keloid scar. I never saw very noticeable scar. So, or one patient cry about the scar, never. Okay, so I think this is very good point. And the other thing is I use monocry. So I have a lot of patients that they are not in my city, and they never come back until 1 month, 2 months. Never, okay? The patient, I told you, I need to see this is not the ideal patient for breast augmentation. And some patients come for breast augmentation. So this is not the ideal patient. I need to talk with the patient. You are not the ideal, I need to do, if you decide to have a very nice breast, we need to talk about another procedures at the same time with the breast augmentation. This is the ideal patient with babies before, and they need volume, very nice body. So those are the ideal patients for any breast technique for breast augmentation, like you do or like mine. Those are the best. The other best patients are very young girls. No babies before, but they decide a little bit bigger. The another cup, for example, those are the ideal for these young girls. Let's go to see the procedure. It's, I do the incision with the scalp. I put the before helocaine with the epinephrine, so, and I wait 20 minutes, 30 minutes. So I never had a bleeding, a real, real bleeding, because I wait after the tumescent, I wait 20, 30 minutes. Then I do the incision, and look, I'm trying to show there that this is the superficial fascia, and the other that I feel it was the fascia from the, where is the pectoral muscle. So between those two fascias, if you see, I just cut a few fat, but because the mammary gland is here. So I'm going to do like a tunnel in the center, under the up, of the mammary gland. So we don't have any, sometimes a peripheral artery that is very common. But if you do the coagulation, it's no big deal. Sometimes it's very near from here. If you see, this is the fascia of the muscle, and I do the tunnel with, and then with my finger, that is the first blunt dissection, I can do the space. Okay, and then with another instrument that also blunt, I can do the space. Okay, if something is bleeding, well, we can handle that. And let me show you this. This is an artery or vein, I don't know. This is in the size or in the upper part. And look at this, it's almost, this is the fascia, some ligaments there, but it's almost no bleeding, and it's no burn. I don't burn too much that space. So it's very, and it's no bleeding at all. This is an agos with antibiotic. I put this before, and then I'll go to do the other breast, okay? So it's no bleeding at all. Look the mammary, look the flap. It's very nice, everything, okay? So I remove this, no bleeding at all. And I don't burn too much, because if you damage too much that area, if you burn too much, capsule. It's because it's a reaction of the body. Okay, then I introduce the implant in just the real space. Sometimes this I can see this amorphic, and then I need to do the just the right size
the right spades in that area. Okay, and only look at this. This is a few deformity here and another blown instrument. So if it's an artery or a nerve or something here, I can damage. Okay, so just I leave this and I tried to put the implant exactly the space. And then this is the superficial fascia. And the other is the superficial fascia too. And I close the superficial fascia first. No bleeding, no damage, no bruising, no nothing. That is very important for my patients. I'm thinking that my patient is my daughter. So I'm trying to do my best. No damage is very important. And then to close the skin, first subdermical, I avoid the tension. And then with the monocryal that I never remove, all the skin. So before to finish the surgery, we check that nothing is in there. And let me tell you honestly, my procedure in this patient is 20 minutes. My real procedure is 15, 20 minutes in both. And then my assistants close. And the other day I do 5 surgeries at the same time. I have 3 operating rooms. I did one, and then I do the other, then I do the other, because it's a very easy for a very good surgeon this kind of procedure. So look at this, my patient immediately after the surgery. 50% of your breast surgeries will be breast augmentation. So try to do the best technique that you can handle. If you see the areolar approach, I never see any patient who complain about the incision, never. Even the axilla, never. So any incision is good. Just you need to explain to the patient where it will be the incision. And I think that it will be very nice if you have a nice result. Then why subglandular, why submuscular? My personal opinion is because I have less, the patient has less problems, less complications with this subglandular, more than that under the muscle.
We have here Bruna. She's a very young girl. She's a very beautiful girl. She has also very nice breasts. She's beautiful breasts. But I agree with her that it's a small breast for her body. So we are going to try to put an implant, and the cap, it will be the next new cap, it will be full C. So she will be look very, very nice.
One of the nice things in the Latin patient is because we have mammary gland, most of my patients. I agree with the Oriental people, they almost don't have, so I don't have experience in that. So I don't have experience in American, Black American people. So I'm talking about the Latin people. Usually they have a mammary gland, so it's more easy for me to camouflage the implant under the mammary gland. So always incision is a small incision, depends of the implant. Look, I try to control, but the anesthesia is in the spinal, okay? Fine. All my patients is the spinal, all my patients with mastopexia with breast implant. Just the tumescent solution is because the vasoconstriction that I need to wait during the surgery. So I inject the solution that is just like a 100 cc's, no more than that, and it's between the two fascias. And I think that with that and to wait, like I told you before, to wait 20, 30 minutes, it will be the best. Okay, you can do something, especially because in my clinic I have everything. So I can check another patient or I can do another small surgery and then to come back to do the surgery. And like I told you, this first procedure, my assistants do that, so I am doing another things. Then I come to do the real surgery, that is like a 15, 20 minutes for me in both breasts. Then if you see, I cut, and look at this, this is the fascia, the superficial fascia in the upper part, and in the lowest. This is the most important point in this procedure. You need to place the implant between the two fascias. So less capsule, all the time, less capsule. As a matter of fact, I don't see 3 grades capsule. 4, never in my life.
4 capsules, never in my life. So one of the most important points is that, to put the implant between those fascias. And look, that the solution is the tumescent solution after 20 minutes wait. And then if you see, it's not bleeding at all, because we don't damage any important structure, especially arteries or veins. So then the tumescent technique, trying to do the packet, trying to do the space for the implant, and trying to protect the arteries, the veins around the mammary gland. And then almost the patient is ready with blunt instruments and to put the gauze with antibiotic. And then I'll do the other packet in the other breast. So it's ready now to place the implant. Look at this, no bleeding at all. That's why I told you that is the most safe surgery for breast augmentation. And then I can use any of, in this case I use this texture implant, but usually I advise my patient that the best is the soft, smooth implant. But if she decides, because they sometimes the patient knows more than you about the breast augmentation of the surgery that they want, especially the breast, because it's very common. And the YouTube and internet, they explain everything. So when I talk with the patient, they ask some questions if you know or don't know about this procedure, okay? So be careful about that, because they know sometimes all the procedure and different kind and implants and everything. So be smart about that. You need to study a lot. Okay, now is the implant in the position, mammary gland don't touch, and look this, to close the fascia, the superficial fascia. That is the other important point. Because if we close, that is the fascia, it's not fat, because if it will be fat, I can close. You see, then the subdermal suture, and then we avoid the tension in that area. So in the future, it will just align. No real scar. So my patients are like the model that I show you. She's a bodybuilder patient. I'll show you the result before and after. And sometimes she is without clothes. Nobody noticed that. Okay. And then that is the monocryl, and that's it. This is the final result in this kind of patient, especially because she is bodybuilder. I'm going to show you patients under the muscle, and you will see the result. Next, please. This is the final. You can see no bruising, no swelling. This is one of the best surgery for the cosmetic surgery, because the next day, the result, they can see the result, they are very happy. Okay, this is one more later, I think, no more, more time later. This is, like I told you, bodybuilder. This is if my patient wants under the mammary gland or under the muscle. Just under the mammary gland, we have just a little bit problem, is the ligaments. So sometimes the ligaments are very strong. Don't fight with the ligaments, because the ligaments is in the fascia of the muscle. If you fight with them, it will be a lot of bleeding, damage, and more burning the area. So try to cut with the electrocautery. That's it. I learned a lot with Dr. Morgan, this approach. I never do it now, but when my patient does the approach and they come with me to replace the implant, why I need to do another incision? So I'm going to do the same incision and to replace the implant. And all the patients have capsule. And fortunately, in this case, the capsule is the first grade capsule. So just I remove the implant and I don't touch the capsule. The capsule is very thin. In case that the patient wants bigger, so I need to cut the capsule to do a new space. If she decides the same size, just I remove the implant, I put another one, another the same size. And just if the capsule is the more hard or painful, I try to remove the capsule, but it's very, very hard to do when it's under the muscle. So I need to talk with my patient. I need to explain the result of the. And then I remove it, I check what size, because some patients come with me 15, 20 years later, and they don't know what size. So I have, fortunately, all the implants in my clinic. And I can check the implant, and I put the same, or depends on the patient wants bigger. And the same, I check that no bleeding at all. The doctor do a very good job before, and it's under the muscle too. So I remove that, no bleeding, because the capsule is without any artery or veins, you know that. So I just check if everything is okay. I open a little bit more the capsule. Probably the patient wants bigger. And then that's it. This is under the muscle. This is the muscle, the pectoralis major. He put the implant under, so I put the implant in the same position. And always I use the soft. And look at the result, it's the same, by the areola and under the muscle. So I saw very nice results always under the muscle. But when they have complications, they have more, a little bit more complications than under the mammary gland. Look at some of the complications with another, the patients with another doctors. If you see, this is a mastopexy with the implant, but it's under the muscle. And when she do the contraction of the muscle, the implant is working in the upper part. So it's the most common complications, because I saw a lot of patients like this. So I don't have too much experience under the muscle, but if I check these patients for another doctors, I imagine that is the most common complication, that the muscle catch the implant and is in the upper part when the patient to that movement. And in this Latin patient, I don't need to put the implant in this area. I need to put the implant here, where is the mammary gland, no, under the muscle. Or when the doctor doesn't have too much experience, look at this. I never will see do that in my patients. Why? Very simple. It's not on. I don't put under the muscle. It's very simple done. So I don't see that kind of complications. Those are patients for another doctors who go to my office to check. Could you imagine if I dance with this girl? So the thing is not a quality, it's because the implant is under the muscle and she can handle that because it's under the muscle. So I'm not going to see this never with my patients, is because it's not under the muscle. And look at these complications with when they have capsule. I didn't do this patient. She bring with me, show me the before, after, under the muscle, after the babies, and then with this contraction with long time, but never come back for the surgery. But look another under the muscle, when it's a cache or clamp under the muscle, look at this, deformity compared with this. I never saw that with my patients, I told you again.
No está en el centro, este es el pezón, aquí debe de estar el implante en el centro, su implante está aquí. La cosa es que cuando lo ponen por debajo del músculo, el músculo lo atrapa y lo levanta. Has contraído tu músculo, entonces al contraer todavía más se ve que el implante, miren, lo está acá, y acá está su glándula mamaria de ella. Ahora sí, otra vez flojito, otra vez levántalo. Entonces miren, dónde está el implante y dónde está la glándula mamaria. Gracias.
So that is the reason that I never put the implant under the muscle. It's more painful, because to put the implant under the muscle is more easy than under the mammary gland. If I have any complications with this approach, that the number one is the hematoma, it's very easy to resolve. Next day I check the patient, they have deformity, they have pain, they have bruising, so I can remove all the quag with the patient without any problem. So when it's for the vein, almost I check and it's no bleeding at all. It's already without bleeding. So just I remove the implant, remove all the clog, or I don't know how to say in English.
Clots.
Coagulos. Okay. And then I show you always these pictures is in the file of the patient because I need to show you. But the final result is the same. This is the next day,
when is the bleeding for the vein? When is arterial is an emergency? Is it the same day? In 4 or 5 hours, you need to go immediately to remove it. Fortunately, I am in my office. I do the surgeries in the morning. I finish my work like at 4 or 5. So when it's arterial, the emergency, I am there. So no big deal for me.
Aquí tenemos a Mayra. Mayra tiene un mes más o menos operada de un aumento de busto. Hicimos una cirugía por el pliegue submamario. La incisión casi no se le ve. Si ustedes ven, casi no se le ve a un mes. Tiene muy bonita caída, pero lo más importante, tiene una cápsula de primer grado, es lo más importante, y lo mismo del otro, ¿sí? Y a pesar de que a ella se le hizo un hematoma del lado derecho, tiene características completamente normales.
She had a hematoma. This is one month later, and this is the same patient. The final result after the hematoma, no big deal.
Miren, aquí tenemos a Teresa. Es mi paciente de hace más o menos 20 años. Le hicimos su cirugía de busto. Está muy bien, pero ya para 20 años está bien que se la cambie. Siempre ha tenido su cápsula. Es una cápsula de segundo grado. Nunca le ha pasado nada. Se los vamos a cambiar porque lo vamos a poner un poquito más grandes. Tiene muy bonita caída, tiene muy bonito cleavage, así es que está excelente. Y su cicatriz ni se le nota. Se le nota más esta de acá, que no sé qué haya sido.
Vesícula.
De vesícula, que en realidad la cirugía que nosotros le hacemos. Que vean una paciente 20 años después con esta cirugía.
20 years before, and she came with me for to replace the implant. But just because she's afraid because it's long time, not because she wants to really change for something. I changed the implant. Look at this. This is the implant with capsule. I remove because it's with calcium there, so I need to remove all the implant and then to put another one. And this is the next day. This is the patient she described before. So I remove the implant. Very easy for me. She wants bigger, so I can put another bigger. The most common capsule is the second grade in my patients. Sometimes I squish and I take with the squeeze the hard scar, the hard capsule. And this is before, this is after. So the surgical care is very easy, outpatient surgery. The bandage compressive for 24 hours, next for 2 weeks, a special bra. Antibiotic, just prevention. Analgesic, just if required, the patient. Check up in 15 days, 1 month, and normal activity in 3 weeks. And let's go to see several patients, because I would like that to show you that I'm telling you the truth. Those are my regular patients. This patient is a young, no babies before. I put the implant, it's 3 months later. The capsule is first grade, it's not suitable. You see, they are so happy. She is without clothes, nobody can see the incision. So she's happy and I'm happy. And it's, I think, so the most important. Another patient, look, this is 3 months later too. And look at this, you see? Is the implant is in the center of the nipple, the areola. Those are very happy, it's natural. So most of my patients are happy with that result.
Okay, entonces vean, mire, puede estar desnudo y no se ve nada. Claro, si levantamos un poquito se ve la incisión, pero está exactamente en el pliegue. Entonces ella puede estar hasta así, verse en el espejo y nunca se va a dar cuenta que tiene una incisión. Entonces por eso lo ideal es poner hacer la incisión ahí, y además el implante está por debajo de su glándula. Entonces esto que ella se toca aquí es su glándula y tiene su sensibilidad de la areola y del pezón.
That's why I'm still doing this procedure, and I'm going to still doing this procedure for the rest of my surgical life, because it's very safe, it's very easy, it's very convenient. Another patient for 13 years, you see, so I'm going to change the implant. It's my patient. She's very happy. Latin patient. No big deal. I'm going just to remove because they are afraid because too many years with the same implant. This is another patient, 17 years. I do this surgery when she was 17. Okay. Now she has two babies or three babies. I don't remember. She came for eyelids. But I took the pictures because after two babies with this procedure that is under the mammary gland, looks natural, looks like nothing. You see, just I took the picture because it's 17 years later, and it's natural, it's without any problem, and I think most of my patients look like that. because I do the surgery, my assistants, I have two assistants with 15 years working with me, with the same procedure, very happy. I check them, no problem. So that is the reason that I'm so happy with this procedure. So just let's go to see another more cases. This is 1 year later, ideal patient for breast augmentation, very young, very nice, two girls. Another, this is the 1 year. This is another, this is 10 years later. This is another with the 1 year later, 500 cc's. This is another with 5 cc's. This patient I remember very well because I did the tummy tuck and I put the implant for the tummy tuck. I never do that, but in this case I do it, I don't know why. So this is another 16 years later. This is another 5, 17 years later. You know, if I show you this patient, it's because if your patients are happy, they come for another surgery. I took the pictures, but I not do just the surgery that. My patients are customers. They are looking for cosmetic surgery, not just the breast. If I do very good job, they come for me for another surgery. So I don't do the surgeries to clients. I do the surgery for customers, because it's very popular now, the cosmetic surgery. So if I do very good job, they come for another, look at this, 14 years later for another surgery maybe. This is 13 years later. This is a bodybuilder that is not my patient, it's a model, but I can see that the implant is under the muscle. And this is my patient, like I show you the surgery. She is a model too, and look at this, she looks more natural than the other patient. Okay. Thank you.